If you had to pick one iconic monster from Warhammer or Warhammer 40,000, then it would have to be the Bloodthirster. And now it has an amazing plastic kit, and in this video series, I'm going to show you exactly how to paint it. Now, in the first part, we're going to do the skin and the wings. And then in part two, we're going to do all the metallics, all the bone, and all the remaining details as well. And as you're going to see, painting this monster is loads of fun. And no matter what variant you're doing, you're going to find something useful in this series. So go grab your paints, and we'll begin. We're going to begin with the most prominent feature on the model, which is the red skin. But before we start painting it, I just want to quickly point out to you that I have built most of the Bloodthirster, except for the hand with the whip, which I've left separate. Now this is because later on it's going to give me easier access to the chest armour and also the face as well when it's separate. But I will be painting it at the same time, and you'll see the red hand will start to get painted as I do the body. And once it's all finished, we'll glue it all together to finish the model off. But for the first colour that you need, you're looking for Khorne Red, and as always, give your paints a good shake before you use each one. And I'm going to be applying quite a lot of this, so the brush I'm going to use is my large dry brush because it's the biggest one I've got. And what I'm going to do is just get some paint and put it onto my palette just to help control how much I've got. And also having a palette allows me to water the paint down a little bit if I need to. Now straight away I won't need to, but later on as it starts drying I probably will. And in that case, use a standard brush to collect some water because you don't want to mix very much into it. So just get some paint loaded on your brush, and all you got to do for this first stage is to start painting all the parts red that you want to be red. And you can be quite rough with this because you need to make sure you cover everything. So I'm really working the paint into all those little details around there. Don't worry about any of the details at the moment though, things like his belt and his armour. We're going to be painting those later on anyway, so we'll come back to that and neaten it as we go. But as you do this, you might find you need to apply a second coat of Khorne Red to get a good solid colour. If you can still see some of this black spray undercoat through it, then, well, you'll need to do that. In which case, just apply a second coat and let it dry. Remember, it's always best to apply multiple thin coats than it is one thick coat. I've applied two coats of Khorne Red now for the base coat, and you can see by keeping those coats thin, I've kept all the detail really sharp as well. And with that done, the next step is to apply a shade all over the red that we've just done. And the colour to do for this is Nuln Oil, and I'm still going to apply it using my large dry brush. Now, when you apply a shade with a brush like this, just be aware that it does pick up a lot of it in one go. So this will be quite messy as you're applying it. But all you need to do is get a good amount loaded on your brush and just start painting it onto all the red areas. And really make sure as you apply it, well, I can see quite a lot goes on. Make sure you just move it around so it's nice and even and you work it into all those recesses so it's settling nicely across the miniature. Now you want to leave this plenty of time to dry, about 40 minutes should be fine. And as it's drying, just keep an eye on it to make sure the shade's not blobbing up towards the bottom of the miniature in particular. If it does, just use your brush like a sponge to get rid of the excess. Now the shade's fully dry, you can see it's really added loads of depth to all that skin and all the muscle. And with that done, we can start highlighting the skin. Now for this, I'm going to be using a technique called dry brushing with a number of different reds. And the first one is going to be Khorne Red, which I'm going to be applying using my large dry brush once again. And it is important that your brush is fully dry before you start this stage, because otherwise you can get a bit of a streaky mess left with the effect. And what you need to do is get a bit of the paint, and you don't need loads. In fact, starting out with about that much is a good start. And what you do is get some tissue and use it to start working the paint in amongst your bristles like that. And you're not looking for loads of the paint to be left on the brush once you've done this. You're just looking for your brush to be looking, well, kind of like that. And all you do is get your model and just start lightly drawing this brush back and forth over the detail. So if I start up here on the head, I'm just going to start running it like that. And you can see because I'm being so light with the brush, the paint just catches on the raised areas and leaves the shade showing in the recessed parts, which is a really easy way of highlighting a miniature. So all you need to do now is do this all over the red for the skin. This will be the first stage, and from here on, I'm just going to keep on brightening that red up still further. Now that we've finished that first dry brush, you can see we're back to that original red, only this time we've got loads of definition on all that muscle. And well, the next thing to do is to carry on dry brushing further, this time with Wazdakka Red, which I'm going to be applying in exactly the same way, really, only with very slightly less paint on the brush. So my brush is completely dry before I start doing this again, but I'm just going to make sure I have very slightly less in there. And once you've got the paint ready, I'm just going to start applying this in the same sort of way, slightly brushing it across the model. And you just need to be a little bit more delicate this time as you apply it, just so you don't get quite so much on, and so that some of that Khorne Red still shows through. But you can see doing this is just starting to brighten up that red just a bit further. And with the Wazdakka Red done, there's now just one more colour to dry brush on the skin, and that is Evil Sunz Scarlet. But this time I'm going to be applying it using a medium dry brush, because we're going to be much more focused about how we apply it, you see. But preparing the paint is exactly the same as what we've been doing before. You just need to put some on the tissue, use it to work the paint in amongst the bristles, and make sure you don't have too much on your brush. And then when you're ready, what you're looking to do is, again, dry brush in the same way, so just lightly flicking your brush across the detail, but this time just be a little bit more, well, light about how you apply it and focus it a bit more on the face for things like sharper details like the ears. So you can see the paint's just picking up on the brow, around his nose and around the mouth as well. When you come to the muscles, what you need to do is just, well, paint it towards the middle of them really, on the raised parts, just like that. So I'm going along those lines to catch them. And then I'm going to leave it where it darkens down in between the muscles and pick it up on the other side like that. So doing this, you see, really emphasizes that muscular shape of the body. So what you need to do now is work around all the body doing this across all of the skin. Remember to do the wings as well, and don't forget the hand holding the whip. And there we are, the dry brushing is now done, and you can see it's given us a really nice leathery texture to the skin, which is perfect for a demon like this. And well, with that done, the next thing I'm going to do is apply a glaze to all the skin of Bloodletter, and this is going to really enrich the red and also bring together these different colours with dry brush onto the model as well. Now to do this, I'll be applying using a wash brush, and well, the method here is going to be quite similar to when we applied the shade all over the model earlier on. You need to make sure you get plenty of this, a good amount loaded on your brush, and I'm going to paint this all over all the parts that we've done red so far. So if I start around here, around the head and the arm again, I'm going to start just painting this on and moving it around the miniature. Now, it's a little bit different from the shade in that I'm not looking for this to collect in any of the recesses, really. I'm trying to keep it even across the whole model. But once you start doing this, I really recommend you keep going until you've finished it. Don't stop part way. That's because you can get a kind of line forming between where some glaze has dried and where you put some fresh on and paint up to it. And with the glaze dry, you can see we've got a really nice effect on the skin now, and well, you could leave it here if you wanted to, but I'm going to add just one more highlight to it, just to give it a bit sharper definition. And if you decide to do this as well, the colour you need is Wild Rider Red. And this time I'm going to be applying it using a fine detail brush, and you need to make sure you use your palette here. So I'm going to put just a bit of the paint on here, and then I'm going to add some water to it just to help thin it down so that it will run smoother onto the model, and just give me a bit more control over it as well. So you don't need a whole lot. But then use your palette to get a good tip on your brush by just dragging it along and twisting it like that to bring the bristles to a nice tip, because what you're looking to do here is paint some thin lines, really. So if I start on the face here, what I'm looking to do is to pick out all the sharpest definition. So if I go on the nose, for example, I'm going to paint a bit of this just running down the lines there just to start picking it out, and a bit along the cheekbones because that's quite a sharp detail along there, you see. So you're just looking at going around the whole model looking for any sharp features like that. Just paint lines like this, and this is really going to start making these details pop out, especially from a distance. Now also, you'll want to do this on things like the limbs as well, so I'll just show you on the arms. Let's get some more paint. On the arms, you get these kind of lines appearing on the muscles, so you can pick out some of these as well, just a few lines along some of those. You don't need to do all of them. And also, if you get any more defined parts, like on the arms, especially down here, along there, you can pick that out with a highlight as well. So just take your time with this part, going around the whole skin. This will be the longest part of painting the red, but it's really going to make a big difference once you've finished. And with that highlight done, the skin, and well, in fact, a massive part of the model, is now finished, and we can move on to start painting some of the smaller details. Now, the first ones of these I'm going to do is the darker bone and also the fur as well. And when I say the darker bone, I mean the actual bone for the Bloodthirster and none of the human skulls or anything like that. So this is going to be things like the horns and the claws and the hooves and that sort of thing. And for this, I'm going to be using Skavenblight Dinge for my first colour, and I'm applying most of it using my large brush, but I've also got a standard brush too that I can switch to for all the smaller details. And that would be things like the teeth and the fingernails and that sort of thing. And well, like with the highlight earlier, I'm just going to get the paint ready on the palette by getting a dollop of it and thinning it down with a little bit of water, making sure I get a good tip of my brush. And all you've got to do is start base coating this onto all the parts that you want to be this colour. And they are scattered around the miniature quite a bit, so I do recommend you look at your box art just to guide you through which bits to do. But well, you're just looking to get an even colour, being as neat as you can as you get close to those red parts. And you will find that you need to apply a second coat of this colour to get a really good solid coverage. But remember to let that first coat dry first of all. Once the base coat's done, the next thing is to add a shade to these parts. And for this, the colour you want is Nuln Oil, and I'm going to be applying it using the same two brushes again, so a large and a standard brush. And the reason I'm using these rather than a wash brush is because a wash brush takes up an awful lot of shade at once, so it's quite easy to lose control of it, and you don't need that much for this part. So just use your palette to make sure you don't have too much of this on your brush, and then you just need to start painting it over all the parts that you've done with Skavenblight Dinge. You want to make sure it settles in all the recesses, so just carefully work it into those parts, but don't put on so much that it starts dripping and that you lose control of it, because you don't want to get this onto the red. When the shade's fully dry, you're ready to start adding some highlights. Now, the colour you need for this is Stormvermin Fur, which I'm going to be applying using my fine detail brush. And the technique we're using here is called edge highlighting. Now, to do this, you just need to make sure you thin your paint with a bit of water so that it will flow easily, and also get that really good tip on the brush, because what you're looking to do here is to paint, lines running along all the edges of the details. So if I start up on these horns again, what I'm going to be doing is sometimes using the side of the brush on quite sharp areas, like down the front of this horn here, and you can just run the brush down that line there, and you see the paint catches that corner and highlights it very quickly for us. Other times though, you will have to keep your hand as steady as possible and just paint along these lines. So these ones, for example, running all the way down the horns like that. Now some of the horns are actually round, such as these ones down here on the arm. So for these, you just need to paint some lines going towards the tip of the horn, just down towards there. And also just around any details on it, like these little cracks that are in the horn as well. Now for the fur, it's the same process really. You're just looking at painting some lines running along the middle of each bit of fur, really, just like that. And you see, doing this just picks out all of that detail. So take your time with this stage, but you'll see it really makes a big difference once you've finished. With that highlight done, the fur's now finished, but for the bone, I'm going to add just one more highlight, this time with Karak Stone. And this is just going to give the impression of it being really sharp towards the tips. And the application for this is the same as what we did before. Fine detail brush still, and just need to thin it down just like before and get that good tip on your brush. And you really don't need very much of this. What you're looking to do is to paint this just towards the tips of all the sharper parts of the bone. So on the horns, for example, I'm just going to focus up towards the tops here. So apply it the same way as we did before, just a little bit on the tip like that. You want to do this on the teeth as well, and any part that you want to appear really sharp. And once you finish that last highlight, all of the darker bones on the Bloodthirster are finished. And we can move on to the last detail that I'm going to show you how to paint in this particular video, and that's the wing membrane. Now the first colour you need for this is Abaddon Black, and you need to apply it using your large brush. And there's not really any special trick to doing this part. You're just looking for a good even base coat over all of the wing membrane. So just make sure you get a good amount of the paint. And what you want to do is just start painting it on these areas here. Now some of the parts are going to be black anyway, but I recommend you get a good coverage over all of it just in preparation for the next step. And you just need to be careful as you get close to those red parts there. You might also find that you need to apply two coats of this to get a solid colour. Once you've finished the base coat, we're ready to start highlighting these parts. Now I'm going to be doing dry brushing for this, and the first colour for it is going to be Dawnstone, and this method is going to be very similar to how I did it before, but this time I'm going to make sure I have very, very little paint on the brush because I want to gradually build up this colour as I go. So I'm using the medium dry brush and using my tissue once again to work the paint into the bristles and make sure that I really don't have very much left on my brush at all afterwards, and you can use the texture of the tissue actually to work that out. See, I'm picking it up there like that. And once you're ready, what you want to do is just start lightly running this across the wings in this kind of direction, so you're going up and down them here, so that the paint will catch on these raised parts of the wings and you start catching that texture like that. Now this will be subtle, which is good, because you want to gradually build up the colour and increase it up to a point where you're happy. And I'm going to focus the grey more and more towards the middle, so by the time I finish this, it's going to get a little bit lighter towards the centre of the membrane just running down there. So you can see that I've built up the dry brush with a couple of layers now, and it's given a really nice effect to the wings. And the next step is to, continue this with another dry brush, but this time I'm going to be using Administratum Grey. Still with my medium dry brush though, and the method for getting this ready is exactly the same as what we've just done. So use your tissue to get rid of most of that paint and really work it in amongst the bristles, so that you've got very little paint left on your brush. And same method really of applying it. You just need to focus this a little bit more towards the middle of the wing membranes. So I'm going to be dry brushing it in the same way, very lightly like this, you see, just gradually building up that colour. And you just keep on going until you get to a point that you're happy with. And with that dry brush done, the wings are now complete, and we've finished a massive amount of the Bloodthirster. It's well on its way now to being completed. So just to recap, on these early stages with your Bloodthirster, it's always a good idea to start out with the main colour of the model, so it's best to start with the red skin. And you can dry brush this and be quite messy with it, because it won't matter at all about getting that dry brush on any other areas that you're going to be painting later on. When you are doing these dry brushes, remember to do them in moderation and gradually build up that colour, so you can get a nice smooth transition from the darker areas to the brighter areas too. Now when you're applying your shades to the miniature and the glaze as well, remember not to put too much on at once because you don't want it to be pooling so much, especially towards the bottom of the model. So keep an eye on it as it dries. And with the glaze, remember that this is different to the shade. You've got to make sure it doesn't pool up so much in the recesses. Keep it even across the entire miniature. Now we're going to move on to part two, in which we're going to be doing the smaller details like the eyes and the tongue as well, but we're also going to be doing the larger details like the metallics and the human bone, and we'll get the model finished as well. So I'll see you in part two.